What you're looking at is a non-working microwave and a pop-up. This pop-up happens to be an A-liner, which is the little A-frame type A-liner that's fully fiberglass. But the microwave is one that's commonly found in many campers. The exact brand of this one is Dometic, I believe that's how you pronounce it, which are the same people that make the refrigerators and lots of other appliances that you find in RVs and pop-ups. What happened to this one right here? The panel just quit working. It was working fine, and one day it just stopped working. So, I'm going to replace the microwave and show you how easy it is to replace the microwave in a little pop-up. Of course, the first thing to do is go ahead and just take the top off, which is normally in most pop-ups, or the countertop, I should say, which in most pop-ups is just, you just pull the lid off. If yours is not like this, then you would probably have to unscrew something. Now, down at the bottom here, I'm going to try to zoom in on these, is the, pardon the camera shake, but at the bottom, right behind, in that area right there, are the hold-down bolts. There's one on the right, and then there's one on the other side, the left side, depending on which way that you're facing this. So you've also got one on the other side. These, as most RV bolts are just square head bolts, and they pop right out, and that's what I'll do right now. Again, I'm looking at the top view, and all I'm going to do is, now that I've got the bolts out, is you just pick it and it will just slide through the front here. And well, I can't do it with one hand, so I'll cut the camera off and slide it through the front. And now that the microwave is out, you can see the brackets are attached to the back of here, and I'll just take those off and I'll use the same brackets on the microwave that I'm installing. Alright, so finally, after three tries, we finally got a microwave that came in that was not bent. We picked one up at Home Depot, brought it home, opened the lid, and this area up in here was literally crushed. So they did not have another one. We went online and ordered one. It got here in about 3 days. Opened the package and it was crushed up here. So finally went back to the store today and they did not have one in the box. So this is the display unit. I checked it out at the store. It works okay. And believe it or not, there's still a small dent right up there still. So I don't know if Home Depot was messing these things up or the manufacturer or what. But we're 3 for 3 with a dented microwave. Here's the only thing that I'll need to do is just come around the back, and the brackets that do the hold down, I'm just going to take out the corner screws, one on this side and one over here on that side, and I'll put the angle brackets on it, and then the next shot will be in the RV. All right, well, that is microwave number 3 installed in the A-liner. If I'd have gotten the right a microwave that wasn't bent, now, this whole project could have been done in less than an hour, but as it was, this thing stretched out over a week. In the back, you can see where the hold downs are. They're right down in there. There's one right over there, and the other one is right over in there. And it's just a simple matter of putting it in there. So if you ever have a microwave that goes out on your RV, just spend about an hour and don't know if you go to Home Depot and pick one up or not, but my wife insisted that she did not want one of those crazy microwaves that had the button that you just grab the door, and I must admit that this time she was probably right. So, hope you got a hint or two out of this and built your confidence. This is John, and I'll see you down the road.